We focus on what we call blue ocean, red ocean. That's a book out of Harvard. And no one turn anybody off telling you it's a book out of Harvard, but it's a good book called Blue Ocean, Red Ocean. And that book talks about, okay, red ocean is, you know, super competitive. Everybody's undercutting everybody. It's price wars. It's whatever. And 90% of the world probably is in that world. That's just, you know, where you are. Blue ocean is figuring out for yourself, where do we win? Where do we typically win? And where do I really want to be in terms of out for a swim? I don't want to be in the red ocean with the sharks. I want to be over in the blue ocean where it's nice and easy and so forth. So we combine those two ideas, the Sandler model of the four kinds of customer, recognizing where we have success is in the pain, and customer who has pain and trouble and needs our help. We want to be needed. And then we also combine that with the relationship. So we have great relationships. We built a good relationship, and the customers will work with us. So that's our blue ocean. Those two aspects are our blue ocean. And as an opportunity flows to us, we evaluate that opportunity based on those two criteria. Does the customer need us, want to pay us to do the work, need our help? Or do we have this super relationship that they've worked with us for 10 years, 5 years, and they'll just work with us because we have a good relationship with them. So those are the two criteria we focus on. If you don't fall into that blue ocean of those two criteria, we're probably not going to engage. However, this is critical. We have to stay in contact with everybody, not just our blue ocean buddies or pain buddies. We got to stay in contact with everybody. And this is kind of the flaw, potentially the weak point in the strategy. I got to keep in contact with everybody as best I can, because everybody moves between those different levels of even keel, pain, overconfidence, arrogance, and what have you. So I've got to keep in touch with everybody. And that's a challenge.
It's just in passing, but the pain criterion obviously is an incentive for them, but it's also pretty easy to discern. I mean, you can tell pretty quickly when you're engaged with somebody that's exploring it, and you find out now they're just looking for RFQs and shopping for the cheapest price on hardware. You know,
they're quoting it out to five people, and we have to stay polite and stay in contact with them. And did they really want me and need me for this situation, or no? They got, you know, their own internal team, and they're the smartest guys, and they think there's 10 people and it's all about price, and we're going to quote it out and we're going to do an RFQ and so forth. And so it just really depends on, it's pretty easy to, from a criteria. So either you've got the relationship. Yeah, we're just going to, they need help with application development. We did some projects for them. We've done successful projects for them before, and they need some help in application development or some other area, and we're going to provide that. Or they're in some sort of trouble or pain, and something's not working, like the example I gave earlier about the ERP system or the QuickBooks system. Something's not functioning right, and we need some help getting it cleaned up. Can you help us?
Folks who work with you, meaning your internal folks. One thing I was always, you said it earlier, there are 300 million targets out there for you.
350,000.
Oh, yeah, 300 million. Yeah, that would be, that's a population. 350,000. A little bit of the idea, do you have to convince your people? Do they have to learn that it's okay? This is, you know, salesmen want to make a sale, I presume. That, hey, yeah. No, let's be polite, build your CRM with these people that we ever send them Christmas cards or whatever you do, but I'm looking for the pain point and move on. And I presume that's hard sometimes for salespeople.
Salespeople, engineers, it's hard for everybody because our culture is a red ocean culture, and so if they've come from a different background, and that background may have been and they were successful in the red ocean. So don't get me wrong, there's a lot of successful companies who are out there in the red ocean, and so they've been in that red ocean, so they bring that with them, and now you've got to deprogram them from the idea of red ocean. Now, if someone comes to me, when Nick came to me as an example from his background, he had some background in the technical space, but he hadn't really been inculcated in the idea of this is the only way to do it. And so he was able to move fluid into our strategy. Or people that I hire from college, they haven't done anything in the world and in that regard, and they come on board. And my daughter came to me after she graduated from college and worked for us in a sales capacity, and she would hear people talking about why we should go after RFPs and red ocean stuff, and she would just shake her head like, why do they want to be there? And because she had never experienced that. She had never experienced to know that, well, that's just what you do in a lot of cultures and a lot of organizations. So it differs.